In this video, I want to show you what is by far the most important secret to sea kayaking. It's the key to quickly developing the skills to be a confident kayaker with peace of mind in all kinds of conditions. I can almost guarantee you that it's not something you've learned before. And there's even a chance that you already learned something which contradicts what you're about to discover. Yet I have seen this one thing transform even experienced kayakers with instructor level certifications. And I've seen beginners learn this, and in a few months or less, they're more agile in their kayak than most paddlers with 15 years of experience. I know it sounds a bit much, but I can't water this one down. I see it making that much of a difference. Before I start, you should know this. If you need to believe that the kayak certification programs have all the answers, and the Inuit who invented the kayak and evolved it over thousands of years couldn't possibly have any wisdom to offer, this isn't the video for you. If you need to see nature as a hostile place that's out to get you, this isn't for you either. You may even find this video painful to watch. I'm Paulo from Dancing with the Sea, and I give sea kayakers the skills they need to feel right at home underwater, but not the way you might think. People ask me, why is it that I only teach kayaking with a Greenland paddle? It's hard to explain in a few words, but by the time you're done watching this video, I think you'll understand why. Kayakers come to me thinking their skills need a bit more fine-tuning, when often the issue is much simpler and easier to fix. Often they want to use the kayak to explore beautiful places. Maybe their low brace doesn't feel quick and strong enough, and they want to feel less anxious when the waves come up. Or sometimes they're struggling to keep up with their friends and they're looking for more finesse because they don't have the strength to use force. If you're using the sea kayak as a way to enjoy your time in nature, this is probably the most important kayaking video you'll watch. By the way, if you're really serious about developing your sea kayak skills and you like what we're talking about and you want to go deeper, you might want to get the free lesson I made for you on how to outfit your kayak for agility. I think you'll enjoy it. You can get it by clicking the link in the description. About 20 years ago, I started using the Greenland paddle. I knew nothing about how to use it, but I loved how smooth and quiet it was. One day, there's about 6 of us on a paddle. The waves were a bit bigger than what I was used to. I was still a beginner. Of course, I'm the only one with a Greenland paddle, and I'm feeling some pressure to prove its worth because at that time, people didn't think much of it. They thought people just use it to be different. I'm at the back of the group and I get on top of a wave, start surfing it a bit, when I lose my balance and almost instantly I'm in the water. But the leader of the group had to say it. It's your paddle. You can't brace with that. It's too skinny. That's what started me on the journey to master the Greenland paddle. I loved paddling with it. If only I could learn to keep myself out of the water. I decided that learning to roll was the solution. I would watch a video demonstration of a young Inuit doing a roll and I would go try it out in my kayak. It didn't work for me no matter how much I practiced. All I did was fall out and swim and get really cold. While watching carefully to find that subtle difference that would help me succeed, I had this realization. In the video, the kayaker was moving his body with a lot more range of motion than I had ever seen before. You just don't see kayakers move like that. Now I think of it as wearing your kayak. When you're wearing something, it doesn't hinder your range of motion and it moves with you. You don't have to worry about your pants falling off when you get up to walk. That's what I mean by wearing. What I saw was the young Inuit moving his body to make the rolls effortless. He had perfect control of the kayak and also could move his body naturally with the full range of motion. Once I figured out how to wear my kayak, everything completely changed for me. And 20 years later, I'm still discovering ways that this simple shift transforms how I feel on the water and how it helps me move with the waves more efficiently. So what does it actually look like when you wear your kayak? Well, you may have been taught to jam your foot pegs in your kayak until your knees are making contact with the top of your kayak. You know, any movement of your hips rocks a kayak. It feels secure. The problem is you can't rotate your thighs without rocking the kayak. That may seem like a good thing, but it has serious limitations. If you can't move your thighs, you can't use them to power your forward stroke, which means less speed and less endurance. I had a kayaker come to me with limited upper body strength, and it was preventing her from being able to paddle any distance with a group because she just couldn't keep up. After she learned to use her hips for power, she not only started going faster, but it also took the pressure off her arms and shoulders and eliminated much of her pain. It allows her to do what she loves when previously she thought her body just couldn't handle kayaking. For bracing, you don't have to react with a quick enough smack on the water to stop a capsize. I was paddling with a fairly inexperienced paddler one time when the waves were starting to build up. We were paddling broadside to the waves, and it was obvious that he was getting more and more tense. Every few waves, he would lose his balance and do a quick brace to avoid going over. I rafted up with him and told him to leave the paddle in the water at the end of his forward stroke until the wave washes over. The Greenland paddle is perfectly suited for this because it moves well in the water. It gives you support as it glides smoothly. Most people wait to be out of balance and then do a brace to regain balance. Every brace wears on their nerves and brings them closer to a capsize. I saw him go from increasingly scared to completely relaxed with a smile on his face. The transformation was instant. Although he didn't have to learn any new skills, he now looked like a kayaker with many years of experience. The Greenland paddle allows you to turn your forward stroke into an instant brace. A lot of kayakers want to move their paddle on top of a bigger breaking wave to avoid having the wave push the paddle deep underwater. That's a Euroblade fear. With the Greenland paddle, you want it to get buried. It's what holds it in place to ensure that you don't get knocked over. That's a pretty big deal when you're getting thrashed around in the waves. Keeping the paddle high on the wave actually helps the wave push you over. Instead of a high brace that almost nobody can do and puts you at risk of tearing your shoulder off, you can simply put your back to the water and rotate the kayak off of you. You just float there. If you can't move your hip back before rotating the kayak, you can't do this. The kayak just pushes your head on the water while you try to force yourself up for a life-saving breath. Believe me, it's a different feeling. And of course, this is also what makes rolling easy. Again, it's not just a paddle. It's not just the body position. It's both working together. You rotate to put your back to the water, rotate the hips to take the kayak off of you. The paddle gives you support as your body moves naturally. These are not difficult to learn techniques to show off how strong and athletic you are. It's techniques designed to keep the hunter safe in extreme conditions so he can keep coming home to his family. So the answer to the question of why I only teach the Greenland paddle, it's not just about the paddle and how it moves through the water. It's not just about how you move your body differently so it feels more natural and gives you more of the freedom of movement, which gives you agility. It's not just about how to use the water to support you instead of trying to resist with force. The genius of the Inuit techniques is in putting all these elements together in a way where you're not an outsider in a hostile environment. You actually feel like you belong there with the agility of an amphibian. I don't know how I could teach kayaking in a different way. To review, the most important thing is wearing your kayak. Having a fit where you can move your thighs to rotate your body and still be able to rotate the kayak, all without falling out. It's this ability to rotate your thighs and rotate the kayak independently that gives you the biggest breakthrough in your kayak skills. And the best way to take advantage of this newfound motion is to use a Greenland paddle because it's perfectly suited to move with you through the water in a smooth, controlled way. It's what allows you to use the force of the water to help you instead of fighting with it. It's more like a dance, and that's why I call it dancing with the sea. When you put all this together, you're not a tourist visiting a hostile place. You feel like you belong there. If you learn nothing else from this video, I hope you come to realize that we can learn a lot from the wisdom of the indigenous cultures. I know some people will say, if these techniques work so well, why is it that we developed a different paddling style that became so popular? I don't know the answer, but I can imagine that we saw the potential in the kayak and decided to try it with a bigger blade and develop the techniques to make that work. I can imagine that we didn't take the time to fully understand what the Inuit were trying to do when they developed the kayak. We never got the true genius of it. And it's my mission to make sure that the world understands this. If you would like to get started with wearing your kayak, I created a free online mini course to help you adjust the fit of your kayak to make it work. Just click on the link in the description and sign up for the free video course. Thanks for watching this video until the end, and if you found some value in it, please share it with your friends.